of friends, Dapper Drabby here, and welcome to a PTCGO match. We are going to be doing the PokeTuber Battle League today, and that is against Professor Red, who is the reigning king of the hill right now. So let's get started. That was very loud, actually. So today we are playing some Dusk main Necrozma. I'll have the list down in the description and a link to Professor Red's video, as well as the Twitter page for the PokeTuber Battle League. Right now we're just waiting on Red to get logged on and ready to play. But let's go over the deck a little bit. We are playing some Dusk main Necrozma, and that is, we're just gonna do it this way right here. We're partnering it with the Trash. So this is an updated version of Tempest Trash, if you guys ended up watching that video. But this is a new league that we're getting started. We're starting with the King of the Hill tournament, and then we're going to do, like, a six-person tournament or something. We're just trying to, you know, grow and make a good collaboration between everybody. I believe next up is whoever wins this match gets to face off against WiseD24, and look, here we go. We're facing Professor Red right now. Let me make sure I pick the right deck. And the right deck is Tempest Trashed PokeTuber Battle League. So let's go. So here's Professor Red. Oh, that's right. I gotta get ready here. You know, put the hat backwards. Ready to battle. Ready to battle. We got our Solgaleo coin here. I won the coin flip. We are going first because we got to get that Garbodor up immediately. We know what we're facing off against. We're facing off against that Malamar Ultra Necrozma deck, as you guys probably guessed by the intro. Let's see what I wonder. Ooh, I have float. So since I have the float, we're going to start things off with the treble and throw the prism on the bench. Let's go. Ooh, he starts off with Dawn. He starts off with the Dawn Wings. We're going to go ahead and float stone that up. Throw down an elixir. Get that onto the Solgaleo Prism Star. I might as well throw an extra energy here. I wish I could, like, discard it right now. More N. We're already doing better than majority of our opponents have. They had a lot of issues with the initial start, and actually I'm gonna start this game off with my Celesteela. It seems to be the go-to. I mean, it is a Dusk main deck. There's more Dusk mains than Celesteela, but Celesteela is just a monster in the beginning of the game. I don't need the Fury Belt yet, so I'm gonna wait to put it down. We will probably go into this because I don't foresee him attacking on our first turn. And we'll leave our Kartana for now. Go ahead, Red. Go ahead, Red. Let's see what you can do. So he's had some very good luck so far. I'm hoping to be the first one to stop him here. Give him some scary face action. Look at that pretty Ultra Necrozma. Rainbow. He gets the full arts. He's upgrading this deck. He's getting it to, you know, that bling status because it's his favorite deck, it looks like. He gets a max elixir hit. Ooh. His Ultra Necrozma is ready already. Can it hit 160, though? I think he needs another max elixir for it to hit 160. Ho, ho, ho. All those things. We got the Garbodor lock immediately. Oh, he has the 160. That's going to put us back a little bit. Who doesn't attack, though? He doesn't attack, though. Okay. So we are going to get the Garbodor lock out. Shut down those Malamars before they even become an issue. We'll put in the... put this guy down. And we're going to grab our other... the Dusk main, so... Ooh, we did drop a frame. That's unfortunate. Hopefully it's not too laggy. I'm trying to be all fancy with the face cam and stuff. And where do I put the metal energy? We have none in the discard, right? Yeah, we have none in the discard, and that's unfortunate. I think I'm gonna have to attack with this guy. Yeah, so we're gonna have to do something strange here, which is like pull this one up, grab this guy, protect our Prism Star here, and go ahead and Dusk Shot the. I feel like I should Dusk Shot the Necrozma because 120 is easier to hit. Now we'll Dusk Shot the Ultra. That way, if we get Celesteela lined up with Moon Press, we can go ahead and knock it out still. Yeah, because it'll have 130. So already, I think we are in a way better spot than most of our predecessors have been against this King of the Hill. So let's just see how it goes. Just waiting on his turn. So yeah, he's trying to get these Malamars out so he can like continuously recharge this. He's gonna try to take out, yeah, he's gonna take out a Duskmane immediately. But in doing so, he gets rid of all these energies, and by getting rid of all those energies, he has no way of bringing it back. So what do I want to do with this? I'm not sure what I'm doing yet, so I'm gonna put this up here. What's your retreat cost? 2. And you do 30 plus 30 for each in retreat cost. So I can power something up right now, but I don't think Celesteela is going to do enough. I see what I want to do. I see what I want to do. First, okay. Do go ahead and grab that. Grab this other Duskmane. Yep. We're gonna go ahead and Beast Ring. And we'll do that on the Celesteela. We're gonna throw away these two metal energies and hope we hit that double colorless energy here. And look at this, we can continue going. Get those last two energies out. Ooh, who to put them on? Who to put them on? Probably this guy. Go ahead and retreat. Do I need the rescue stretcher for anything? No, not at this time. And then go ahead and Moonblast. Knocking out the Ultra Necrozma. Getting the first, or second two prizes. So he's already got two prizes, but it set us up to Beast Ring and just go off. So he's gonna. I think he's dead drawing. He must be. He's getting nothing right now. He's bringing the Ultra back, though. Bringing the Ultra back. But we are in the clear lead here. In the clear lead. We got all of our energies on board. And we're doing it to it, man. And the float. He's getting floats everywhere. Some max elixir action. He does have the backup max elixir for this, and he's gonna beacon. For those two Malamars. So it could be wise for us to get, ooh, that's nice. So here I could Dust Shot this Ultra Necrozma again. That's clearly what he's going for. And I just have too many options here. Could Cyrus. I don't really need any other cards this turn. The only plus side would be to get the next Duskmane set up so I can just clear him out. I need to take prizes though. So I either Dust Shot or I Blaster here. Since I don't have the Guzma to go ahead and try to Blaster. Might be best to Dusk's Shot here. Set up that next KO. Since I have no other thing to use this turn, we're just gonna Cyrus here. And unfortunately, that's what sucks. I took out the fourth Guzma for Cyrus. But look how detrimental this is. Just one moment. Look how detrimental this is going to be for Red. Sorry, I'm a jerk. I'm just a jerk, guys. But yeah, I'm loving this deck. I'm building it at home. That's craziness. So we do have a Kartana in here. We'll just grab it out. So it's not in the deck anymore. And I'm wondering, actually, should I go ahead and grab that Treble, the Trubbish here? I feel like I should get rid of a Cynthia and a Kartana to grab some Trubbish. We'll wait on the float stone. But then I'm just gonna Dusk Shot. The Ultra Necrozma. Set it up to be able to be one shot by Celesteela. Yeah, but see, like I said, that was so detrimental getting those two Inkes up after he just grabbed the Malamars. Cyrus is just crazy good in this deck. Especially when they're like, you have to hold it though. You have to hold it until about mid game. And then Cyrus is just so detrimental. So detrimental. It's really. I really feel mean doing it, but. Which makes my deck so good. So good is that Cyrus. And see, I haven't even had to use Lele, so this is pretty. This is not budget, I would say, but it's not hard to build. Like, I have a Lele in here for just in case moments, but that just makes the deck better. I don't even use it. Knew that was coming. This is why I kept this guy. It's why I kept this guy right here. It sucks because I have to continuously dash shot now until I can retreat, but that's fine. Actually, I could just like multi-switch retreat into Solgaleo Prism Star and then get all that energy back on the board. Inkay Malamar. Alright, so he used one Field Blower. Ooh, we get the Fighting Fury belt. That is crazy good. Yep, that's what I'm gonna do. Multi-switch. Take a card off of you. Throw the Float Stone here. Throw the Fury Belt here. Retreat into the Prism Star. Question is whether or not to. Yeah, might as well. We'll throw these two guys back in the deck. And Cynthia. We get our last float stone. Not that we need it right now. We could get the next Garbodor up. So we'd have double Garbodor. But I don't think we need it right now. So I have four energies down here, right? Four energies. So two are going here. And I think I can put two here. So I have all my Ultra Beasts set up. 4 to here. There we go. I'd hate to be staring down my board right now. I would hate it. Alright, guys, one sec. I gotta make sure my computer's plugged in so I don't lose power. There we go. Just better be safe than sorry. Safer than sorry. So he's going to town. This is a long match. Ooh, parallel city. That's a nice one. What do I want to get rid of? Keeping the big guns. So I guess I'm getting rid of this guy and this guy. This makes most sense. Although that does not bother me. Because we're going to take our second knockout right now. With Celesteela. Moon Press. Well, look, there's our Layla and our. And our Beast Energy. So, see, I didn't even notice. Really? Just like, I'm done. He basically gave up there. Wow. We had three energies in the discard pile, guys. So there you guys go. Duskmane coming over Malamar, but if you guys want to take a look at Red's deck, again, a link to his video and his channel will be in the description, as well as I'll put his video at the end of the game, the end of the match. I'll leave it up somewhere. Up there, but here's an idea of what he was playing against, what he was playing against me. But I was able to take it, guys. I took it. I took the crown. It is mine, my crown now. So I will be facing off against WiseD. So cool. I want to thank you guys so much for stopping by. This has been Dapper Drabby. I'll bid you guys alola, and I hope to see you in the next match. Bye bye.